Hey guys, it's Spiffyguy and I'm out here with another around the home video, another garden update. And what we got growing on today is compost. I got 2 cubic yards of compost delivered and it's still steaming. So what we're gonna do is refresh the beds, not the bread, and go from there. Little update on the garden barrel. I was gonna replace the garden barrel. I'm having a little issues sourcing a plastic barrel on Craigslist. The guy I normally get it from apparently doesn't do it anymore, so I gotta find another source, and making sure that they're food grade ahead of time, it's kind of hard because some people don't really know. So I may end up just using the regular garden bed again this season until I can get my hands on one, maybe swap it out mid-season, we'll see. But I got a lot of dirt to move, and we're gonna go ahead and cover the beds. All right, so I've been at it for about an hour. I got almost half the pile done. And I got quite a bit done on the beds. I'll take you back there and show you. I'm gonna have extra dirt. That's just, I knew that going into it. I probably only needed about 1.5 yards and I ended up getting 2 yards because the delivery is high. I got this stuff from St. Louis Compost, which their premium gold is an organic certified. So, and it's 32 bucks a cubic yard, which sounds high, but that's 27 cubic feet. And if you compare that to the, you know, half cubic foot bags you're getting at the store, in the long run, it's a lot cheaper to buy it in bulk like this. Unfortunately, the delivery fee is high, and I didn't have a truck that I could use to go and pick it up. And I looked at like Home Depot and Lowe's and things like that on renting a truck. But the trucks there would only take probably 1 cubic yard due to weight. And so I'd end up having to make more than one trip. And when I calculated the mileage and the time, it was pretty much on just about on par. I may have saved 10, 15 bucks. And honestly, it was a lot easier to just have somebody dump it there than for me to drive around for 3 hours trying to pick this stuff up. So anyway, let's go in the back and take a look at what we got going on. So this is that corner bed. You can see that I put the picket on there and I raised it up. It's pretty much full. And I went ahead and filled up the onions. I'm gonna put in a different type of onion in there. So I wasn't too worried about covering up any starts or anything. I'll pull the ones that overwintered and replant direct. So the green onions do great, but I wanna do a refresh on the bed. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pull out the green onions that are in there and replant from seed. And that way I can put in compost and raise the level up. If you're going to compost with plants already in there, you want to make sure that you don't bury them too much, because some plants will get like a stem rot in on them, and that could be an issue. So what you might need to do is you might want to dig out a circle wide enough to get all the roots, lift the plant up a little bit and shove some soil down there, and that way the plant comes up to the level of your compost. I went ahead and filled these up as well. I've got the hose that comes off the irrigation there, and it's kind of buried. I'm not really too worried about that. I probably should have done something slightly different on the irrigation as far as getting it into this bed, but lesson learned. You know, I've got the ball valve right down there. It's a little tight, but you know, worst case scenario, I can always pull some of this stuff up and revamp it, but it's working for the most part. I went high on this bed, and the reason being is this stuff is going to settle, so you want to go a little bit higher knowing that it's going to drop down. And so I went right up pretty much kind of above the string line there, and knowing that it's going to settle. This is a fantastic refresh on this. And I wouldn't normally do a full load of compost every year because it is kind of expensive, but if I can make compost enough where I have, you know, you know, 5-6 buckets full of compost in the spring that I can just kind of put in with the plants as I'm going, then that would kind of work. Mainly with this, I wanted to bring the beds up to height. So one of the things I did also was I have silver maples and they drop sticks everywhere, and so you can see I have sticks and stuff in here, and that's kind of a bit of a I guess a hugel culture idea. But I put the sticks down knowing that I'm going to raise, you know, 6 inches. And those sticks will just provide some sort of organic, you know, material back into the soil once they degrade. And I don't think they're going to cause any problem. So just a way to get rid of those sticks. And because they don't really compost so well. And I don't have a chipper. So if I had a chipper, then, you know, obviously I'd just chip them up. But there you go. So I have a lot of compost left over, because I'll fill this one and then I'll do a refresh on the strawberries and then do a refresh on this garden barrel, because like I said at the beginning, I don't know if I'm going to be able to find another barrel, so I'm going to continue on with that until I can find a better option. But any leftover compost I have, I'll put out in the mint bed out front, and then I have some patches in the yard that I'm going to put the compost down and seed. You don't necessarily need to use your compost always on your gardens, so just keep that in mind. There's a lot of motorcycles and trucks, so I'm going to get back to it, and we'll check in a bit. I just want to show you guys a quick shot. You can see how much of a level we're adding of compost in here. And if I needed to, I could always remove those eye hooks and move them up a little bit. But once again, I'm not really too worried about the string. I can always raise the string up to the top of the soil because the soil is going to settle. So, and as any good parent does, I've enlisted the help of the compost monster since we're dealing with compost. And he's doing a great job. So we got all the beds filled, every single one. This one looks just pristine. Look how awesome that looks. The compost is tight on the string line. The quarter inch line is laid out, ready to roll. I need to put the quarter inch line over here, but Home Depot is missing some parts and I want to swap out that right angle down there. Now I did end up covering up that ball valve, and I know if I put a plant there, it'll be in the way, but I don't really mess with the ball valve last year, so I think I'll just dig it out. Okay, so we finished up mulching. We've mulched up the strawberries, which I kind of went and pulled out some of the dead strawberry leaves. I was surprised how little plants survive through the winter. We'll see what happens when they start coming back. I need to get a bunch of different plants down here. The ones that I had up top, which were these quinults, they're a bit aggressive with the runners, so I want to try and find something else to put in there. So, you know, I was thinking about this thing. We went ahead and packed the compost into the garden barrel. That way it was ready to roll. But I'm thinking that I might try to turn this into a potato bucket. I talked about this in my kind of my overview, is one of the things that I was going to do once I replaced this bucket with a wicking one. But I think what I might do is I might empty it, take the legs off, and, you know, fill the bottom with some garden cloth. Just kind of keep all the dirt in there because there will be a big hole from the compost tube. And then cut it, you know, like, I guess like right about there, maybe 12 foot section or 12 inch sections. And then on the sides, use either some 1x, you know, 1x1s or some sort of mending plates screwed in there that it can slide up on top of each other and stack. And then do potatoes in the bottom, and as the potatoes grow higher, you just sack up another one and fill in more compost. I don't know, I think it'd be kind of a neat idea, and, you know, they do it with wood really easy. So I might do that just because, I don't know, I'm not too too thrilled with the pockets on there. And, you know, if I'm putting potatoes in there, I could put pockets, or fill the pockets as well with plants as I go. So anyway, but all the beds are filled. This one is all the way up to the top, which is looking nice. I need Home Depot to get their plumbing parts in, or at least out on the shelves, so I can finish up the irrigation. And that way the irrigation will look like this. If you look, isn't that beautiful? Everything's all nice, the string's tight, and I use that quarter inch line, and I'm digging that. I'm gonna put the quarter inch line over there. So everything's looking good. We're doing great. Kids are doing some cleanup on the zoysia out here, and the trash can composter is full of leaves and the zoysia grass, and we'll use that for mulching material as the season progresses. And I also took some of the compost and I stuck it into the compost barrels to kind of help kickstart it a little bit, and mix their microbes with my microbes. And I cleaned out underneath it, and we also planted, put some milkweed in the back. It's not full sun, but we'll see if it comes up. Let's see, what else is going on? One of the things I'm going to do is, as you can see, I do square foot gardening. This bed is primarily going to be all peppers, hot and sweet, and tomatoes. And I'll do another video where I talk about what I'm going to put out here and kind of how I plan out. But I think in between the plants along the lines, I think I'm going to plant things like radishes and lettuce and spinach, things that aren't going to get really high and they're not going to get in the way of the plant. And that way I can maximize my space. And it's just something to kind of fill in and get a little bit extra out of there and kind of companion planting. So just pay attention to what plants go well with each other and what don't. So like originally I was going to put some tomatoes in here, some martinos, and I was going to put dill right next to it. And apparently tomatoes and dill don't like each other. So now the dill is going to the other side and the tomatoes will go over here, and life will be happy. We'll put some cilantro and things in between to make them behave themselves. Right here though, you can see in the patio picker, I used up the rest of my radish seeds, and we planted this about a week ago, and things are coming up. So I really don't know what to do as far as planting, because it's 70 degrees right now and our last frost date is still 6 weeks away, which I'm way behind on my seeds. So let me take you down in the basement. I will show you quickly what I got going on for the seed starts and how we're going to do that this year. All right, guys, I don't know if you remember the PVC light rack, but I've changed some things up and put some storage in here. And so I made sure to keep this bottom shelf kind of open for our lights. These lights are 36 inches. Would have been nice to have a 4 foot, something a little bit longer. I may try to find a little square LED grow light kind of thing to fit in there. But that's kind of what I'm running off of. I've got a timer with a power strip, turn the lights on and off. I'm doing, I believe it's a 14 hour cycle, something like that. Anyway, and I forget the wattage on the bulbs. I think they're 65. You'll have to go back and take a look at the video that I did on that. But what I'm going to be doing is, last year, a couple years, I've been using these 4-inch pots, and to be honest, they're a little hard to kind of fit as many as I need in there. So I'm going to try, I picked up some of these, so I'm going to try these trays with the 4-inch. Really, we only have 6 weeks left until the last frost date for us, and I doubt we'll make it that far. Honestly, I think we'll end up out before then. So I'm not really too worried about the plants getting root bound in these little small 3-inch plastic ones. And I have a few more trays that I picked up, and I can fit 4 trays underneath there. So, and as you can see, I got junk all over the place, but I squared off a little spot for these things. So I'll put the 4 trays down there, and that should cover all of my plants. As I said earlier, I'll do a video on exactly what I'm going to be putting out where, but I'm looking at starting about 60 some odd plants, tomatoes, peppers, pumpkins, that sort of thing. And most everything else will be direct. So all my cucumbers and greens and that sort of thing. I'm really kind of limiting the stuff that I'm doing this year and concentrating on the peppers and tomatoes for canning, cucumbers for pickling, that sort of thing, and just plain eating, and then a lot of greens and herbs, that sort of thing. So that's what my plan is. So anyway, that's about it. That's what I've got going on today. I need to get some more plumbing parts for the irrigation, and I need to get these seeds done, because, well, let me tell you, we need to go. So my seed order came in a couple days ago, and I'm ready to roll. So we'll check back with you as things get going. I want to encourage you guys to go out and start getting your grow on, because there is still time left. Even if you've just got a pot out there with some spinach in there, it's growing your own food, and that's important for health and self-reliance. So just remember that life is an adventure, and go out and have one by growing your own food.